Good afternoon, YouTube. So I've been using this Dezcal descaling powder in my Breville Barista Express coffee machine. So I picked this up 2 years ago off of Amazon. I'll put a link to this. This works pretty good. About $17 for the whole bottle. I've used half of it in 2 years. And that's descaling the espresso machine about once a month. And I use approximately 1 ounce. As you can see, there's my instructions. I use 1/8 of a cup or 1 ounce, 28 to 30 milliliters of powder or 2 tablespoons. That's how much is in their individual packets if you buy the stuff pre-packaged. If I had used white vinegar, which I started using, you use a quart of vinegar per cycle, and in a year I would use 3 gallons of vinegar, and at $3.50 to $4 a gallon, you're looking at $11 or $12 per year for vinegar. This has been 2 years, maybe $4 a year for this powder. So quite a bit more economical, but this works out to $17 a kilogram. And I went to their website. Here's the safety data sheet, Dezcal Descaler. And the ingredients, citric acid, about 60%, sulfamidic acid, or also known as sulfamic acid, and that's about 5%. And then aluminum sulfate, about 1%. So that adds up to about 2/3 of the material, 66%. These things here don't cost anywhere near $17 a kilogram. In fact, right here I bought 25 pounds of citric acid for about $50 delivered. And let's see, that came from the chemistry connection. I'll put a link to this in the video description. You're looking at $2 a pound for this. And then I got some sulfamic acid, 2.5 pounds. This was about $13, so you're looking at maybe $63. And then there's some aluminum sulfate. This was 2 pounds. I think it was around $10. Let's go back here and look here. So, you know, if you look at this, it's about 60 parts citric acid, 5 parts sulfamic acid, and then 1 part aluminum sulfate. If you ignore the other third over here, whatever that is, that's about a 12-to-1 ratio. So with 25 pounds, I would want about 2 pounds of this. So I think 2.5, that's about 1 in 10. If you take 1/60th of 25 pounds, I think a 1/2 pound of aluminum sulfate would basically make this. And one of the reasons I'm making this instead of buying this bottle like this, so I want to use this in my espresso machine, so I need about 12 ounces per year. I also want to use this in my tankless water heater, and for that I'm going to need to make up about 2.5-3 gallons of descaling liquid, and I'll need something like 10 or 12 ounces of this compound here. So I'd use pretty close to a full bottle of this in a year. So the net cost here is about $70 for all the materials, and I'm going to make about 28 pounds. So that's what, maybe $2.50 a pound roughly, and maybe $5 a kilogram. So it's about 1/3 the price of this. Oh, okay. Yeah, it is just a large bag. So what I figure I'm going to do, I picked up a Home Depot bucket with a gasket sealing lid because I want to keep this airtight so that it doesn't absorb moisture. Citric acid, 25 pounds. This is food grade citric acid. This is food grade sulfamic acid. And this is food grade aluminum sulfate. So I made sure to get the food grade because I'm going to be using this in my espresso machine. Okay, so got my dust mask and safety glasses on. Keep this powder out of my eyes. Also working outside, so hopefully the breeze will keep the dust down. A little bit of sulfamic acid. I want to kind of mix this in layers, so it's, this is going to be kind of hard to see
how well you mix it up because everything's a white powder. So I weighed out 8 ounces of the aluminum sulfate. So I'll put that in there. Figure I'll try my drill here. Okay, just I guess lather, rinse, and repeat. And let's see, I think I can dump the rest of this in here. Now that I got the bag emptied out. Okay, there's the rest of the citric acid. And that's the rest of the sulfamic acid. The rest of the aluminum sulfate. Okay, I think I need a bigger mixer to get down there deeper. So this is like a paint mixer in my cordless drill, and I'm on low speed. Yeah, I find it works better if you run this in reverse. Kind of pulls the material up and mixes it better. Okay, I think that's going to do it. So we've got ourselves about 28 pounds of homemade Dezcal, just like this. Same ingredients here. So I think with this, you were using approximately 30 milliliters or 1 ounce for 1 quart or 1 liter of water. But since this is about 1/3 filler, or the active ingredients are about 2/3, you'd probably want to use something like 2/3 of an ounce or 20 milliliters per liter or quart of water. So this is a little more concentrated because I don't have any fillers in it. And the nice thing I like about this over white vinegar, one is it works better, two is it's less expensive, and then the third one is this was 2 years worth of use. That would be 6 gallon jugs of white vinegar, and then another 6 gallons. So, you know, in my hand, I'm holding the equivalent of 12 gallons of white vinegar. It's a lot easier to store this. Here I'm going to have maybe 15 to 20 years worth of powder. So, but yeah, just thought I'd show you my Dezcal substitute here. Homemade, do-it-yourself descaling powder. So I'm going to put the lid back on here. I think what I'll do is keep this inside just so I kind of remember my recipe, and I might also keep this in here too, just so I remember where this is. It also is a good soil acidifier if you have plants like blueberries or azaleas, plants that need acidic soil. This is a good soil additive. So I was looking up what these different compounds do. So both of these acids are what dissolve the calcium and lime scale that builds up in either your espresso machine or your water heater. And I guess they use a mix of acids. Just maybe citric acid is better at dissolving one kind of scale, and sulfamic acid is better at a different kind. This aluminum sulfate, on some of the coffee machine forums, people think the aluminum is to protect things like aluminum parts in your machine. Now, Dezcal recommends not using this on any machine with aluminum, and I don't think most machines have much aluminum parts inside. You know, they're usually copper or stainless steel. Like the tankless heater is copper, brass, stainless steel, and I think the espresso machine is similar. But what the aluminum sulfate seems to be used for, at least industrially, it's used in water treatment plants, places where they're working with things dissolved in water. And apparently the aluminum sulfate helps bind to dissolved minerals. So these acids dissolve things like calcium carbonate and your lime and scale buildup. They dissolve that. This aluminum sulfate bonds with those minerals, causes them to precipitate, and clump together so that those materials either sink to the bottom or float to the surface, depending on what they're consisting of. But anyway, there's my homemade version of Dezcal. Probably about a third the price of the big bottle. It should work just as well. A little more concentrated here since I'm not doing the 33% other stuff that's not an active ingredient. So yeah, if you have any questions about that, go ahead and post up in the comment section down below. I'll try using this in the coffee machine when I next need to descale it. And then in the next video, we'll take a look at using this in the tankless water heater. See how it works there. So stay tuned for that video. If you haven't already done so, you can subscribe with the link in the lower right corner. I'll put those other videos over here on the left side. And as always, thanks for watching.